Let's get this show on the road. Actually, let's just flip that upside down for me. That's a faith healing strike. Strike, and we start with one item, Holy Avenger. I've got a plus one bonus to attack rolls against adjacent monsters. Increase the bonus to plus three against undead monsters. Oh my god, that is lucky. I have the Holy Avenger sword. Well, there you go. Might have been the move of the game. Let's see, let's put this stuff. We start in the key. So we go. That's about center. Can you see that? Alright. And this, where's the corner of the game board? It's about the corner of the game board. I guess you could hide stuff from underneath, huh? This here. Finally, we're gonna start, right? Tilt. There we go. Good enough. That's a weird background. What do I have there? Enough for the solo game I'm playing. So, I guess I should have kept this part up. It tells me how to play, right? Adventure setup. It's completed. Place the sun there. Special adventure rules. Whenever the hero explores and draws a new dungeon tile, with a white arrow, move the sun token one circle to the right. When you move the sun token to the last time track, Strahd wakes up. When you wake up, find his villain card, activate the start of your villain phase. You win the game and the hero starts his own turn on the secret stair tile. Heroes lose if it's 0 hit points. No healing surge tokens. We're going to start with, we'll do two healing surges. When we begin, breathe. actually, wait. You wake up alone in the depths of Castle Ravenloft. The last thing you remember was not this song. Come on.
Hang on. Like I said, I'm starting a new Pandora channel.
Let's see, where was I? You wake up alone in the depths of Castle Ravenloft. The last thing you remember was when the man with the piercing eyes and long cape approached you in the dark, on the dark street outside the inn. Really, Star Wars? Well, it had to be Count Strahd, the vampire. Outside the castle, you know that the sun is high in the sky. Now you have to find your way out of here before the sun sets and Strahd returns to finish whatever foul plot he began last night. Alright, so. Let's get the sun up here. Does that be visible there? Boom, there's the sun on track one. I start anywhere on Strahd's crypt. There we go. So, hero turn. I can move and attack, or attack and move. And explore. We will move and explore. Bummer. It is a black tile. I draw a monster. A blazing skeleton. We'll put a blazing skeleton upon the mat. This is there. Would that be a close up? Good enough. Then exploration phase is complete. After the exploration, since it's black here, we have this happen. I need to find some glasses so I can read these tiny little things, because I'm old. Oh, these are great, I got these monster glasses, how's that? You fall through a mysterious portal, reappearing elsewhere in the crypts, covered with wounds. Attack the active hero 3 times. Remove the active hero from his or her tile. At the start of the hero's next hero phase, place a hero on any tile. You know what? It doesn't work so well, but might as well do it. Oh, you know what? I don't even have a die, do I? Attack 1. 8 plus 17 is a hit. That's once. 5 plus 8 does not make it past my AC of 16. And the last attack is 20. Luckily there's no criticals. So I get hit twice. My first turn, I haven't even done anything yet. So, let's put 2 hit points on there. One of those. close. This is back before they started. They started making them later. They have little, like, hurt marks on the back. However, there. So I've taken 2 hit points. I go off the board. That means his, none of his stuff fires. Moves one tile to the nearest hero. There is no hero. So I can then return back at the start of my next hero phase on any tile. Which I guess I will. Oh. Blazing Skeleton has 2 hit points, but I can use the Shield of Face within one tile of me. So I could actually do it from here. So I will do it from here. No, I will do it from... Let's see what the advantage is. If it's within one tile, he does a fireball. Otherwise, he moves. So no matter what, I'm screwed. But I can get further away this way. So, I will do Lance of Faith. Attack one monster within one tile of you. If that monster is undead, you deal +1 damage. I add 6 to this. 8 and 6 is 14, which is good because his AC is 13, doing 2 points of damage. Killing that, this goes into my experience points. Excellent. At will, so I can use it more. I will explore this direction. Oh no, it's another. To note, see these little arrows. Those always face the explorer, which will be used later for driving the bad guys. On a black tile. Well, on any tile, you draw a monster. It's a kobold skirmisher. There he is. They go on the little coin, or the skull spots. They go at the start of the villain phase. However, at the start of the villain phase, if you have not explored, or if you explored and found a black triangle, you do a red card, which is encounters. And then you have to read the absolutely tiny text, which we will do this way. Acrid yellow smoke fills the crypt, causing you to choke and cough. Attack each hero on the active hero's tile with it. Add 6 to the roll. Has to beat your AC. That's 14. Does not beat my AC, but a miss does 1 damage anyway. So I have not gone really anywhere, and I have lost 3 hit points. And now it's the start of the villain phase, where the kobold, and they have pre-programmed text on what they do. I don't know if you can see it up there. Anyway, do better next time. If the kobold is within one tile of your hero, he attacks the closest hero with a thrown javelin. So he will throw a javelin at me. A roll of 5 and add 9, that makes 14, which is also below my AC, armor class. So he misses, which makes it my turn. I can move 5. Diagonals can count as well. I will go 1, 2, 3, 4, wanting to put some distance between this guy and myself. The monsters move by tile. These are squares. Each individual square in any tile. get to an edge. Oh, shoot. Wait. Let me start my turn over. Here you go. Busy talking. I can use my Lance of Faith within one tile of a monster. It's that one. He's not undead, so it doesn't have its extra special power, but I add 6 to this. And I don't get to count it because it fell off the table. 18 is already going to be above his AC. That will do 1 point of damage. So my Lance of Faith will kill the Kobold Skirmisher, and I now have 3 experience points. These are good things. Experience points will allow me to avoid these red cards, which are just kind of random damage. So I attack, now I will move. 1, 2, 3, 4. And an edge, I will explore. Aha, it's a white tiled, white arrow. However, that moves the sun. So the sun is starting to set. This also comes with its own monster, another kobold skirmisher. You can't have two of the same... One player can't have two of the same card. That'll be when I play with other people, it'll make more sense. Is that... Well, that's a hard one to explain. Another player can have a kobold skirmisher. And actually, then both kobold skirmishers would move whenever a player has one of those cards during the villain phase. So... We're at the villain phase. If I did not place a new monster or a new tile, or if this had a black, we would draw a red. However, we don't because it's white. Then comes the bad guy's turn. The Goblin Skirmisher is within one tile, so he will throw a javelin at me. He rolls a 20, which will hit, doing 1 point of damage. I have lost 4 out of my 8 hit points. But his turn is up. Now. I can go adjacent to him. 1, 2. And I can use my healing strike. Choose one hero within one tile of me. I will choose me. That hero regains 1 hit point if I hit. Okay? To add 8 to this. 6 and 8 is 14. He's a 13. That kills him. I gain 1 more experience point. Now I have 4. When I have 5, I can avoid encounters. And I gain 1 hit point. So I'll put that back here. So now, villain's turn, nothing happens. Let's see. Move this closer here. Oh, I don't know what that looks like. What does that look like? Is that confusing, isn't it? Because I've got underneath. Do I have something to put under there that won't be confusing? Just a minute. I think I have. Well, except I have to move everything. I've got this wonderful green mat that I should have put underneath there. But I did not, so let me put something else. So I don't have to redo the whole game for you. Hang on. Blue work. Easy enough to slide underneath this. That looks better, I guess. And actually white maybe as well. Oh. Well, sorry. I'll make it look better next time. How's that? Dun, dun, dun. You can see my camera. I got it. That's how big it is. If that gets confusing, we'll change it. Anyway, so where was I? I killed that guy, I moved over there, so I will explore. Draw a tile. The chapel. It has its own yellow, white thing. I'm gonna move, white triangle, I moved the track. Oh no. Strahd's gonna wake up. I don't want him to wake up. There's a spider there. Unless I've taken the spiders out of here. There's a spider. You know what? That needs a bigger thing to sit on. Except this bigger. Okay, the spider, if it's adjacent to the hero, which it is not, if it is within one tile, it is. It attacks the closest hero with an acidic web. No! Well, that's 11 to this. It's going to hit. 24. The web hitting does one damage to me. Slowed, which gets me a condition marker. I'm now slowed. And place the spider adjacent to the hero. I guess it comes to me, webs me, and races next to me. I will leave it on this tile. You have the choice when it says adjacent to put it in any adjacent spot. I'm putting it adjacent, but also a tile away. That way it'll be easier to run away from them later. Awesome. That's the end of their turn. My turn. I am adjacent. I'm slowed. My speed is 2. Then I get to discard it at the end of the turn. I will go ahead and use my Healing Strike, which is an 8 plus 8 and 8 is 16. That will hit it. It's a 15. So I heal one. I kill it. It's worth 2 experience points. And now I can move 2, which I will do diagonally here. 1. And I will explore. Find a crypt corner. It is black tile, which means after I place my monster, this goes away by the way, another blazing skeleton. Actually, this blazing skeleton I have already climbed. How about that? There's him. That blazing skeleton. We'll go in a second, but first, have an event. Cold, spectral hands grasp at you. Before you can react, one of your items is gone. Oh no, you know what? I never even used my item, which had a +1 bonus to attack, a +3 damage to undeads. You must discard... Oh, crud! You know what else? Hang on. Totally forgot something. Totally not cheating, but cheating. After killing each of these things, you're supposed to get a treasure card. I should have 4 treasure cards. 1, First one, burst of speed. I could have moved my speed. Didn't do it. It's gone. Second one was rejuvenating onslaught. Until the end of your next hero phase, I would have got an extra point. I didn't. Didn't have it. Item, amulet of protection. Okay, so that's here and there. And healing potion. Used during your hero phase. We got that last time. I'd have drank it. Which means it's not here, so I might lose my important stuff. Now then, one of these two things about odd, it's the amulet of protection, even it's the Holy Avenger. Odd, amulet of protection goes away. Still have the Holy Avenger, which is really good, but I haven't used it. Oh, it would have been my choice anyway, it said. But I made it not my choice because I screwed up in the first place. All right. Now then, Blazing Skeleton. Within one tile, it attacks each hero on the closest tile with a ball of fire. No! Add 7 to this. 1! Nice! But it still does 1 damage even for missing. But that was good, it would have been 2 damage. Oh, and I could have discarded those cards to avoid that other card. Now, I face a dilemma. Run towards this thing, because it's further from Strahd's crypt, because Strahd, when he comes awake, will follow me. And that is, the further away I am, the better. So, I have 2 hit points, that's no big deal. I want to use the Holy Avenger. So, that's a +1 bonus to my attack rolls against monsters that are adjacent to me. Well, shoot. Why that's a bummer is because I want to get farther away. Although, you know what? If I don't explore, I can avoid whatever that is. So I will get next to him. Right here. I will use my Healing Strike, which gets a +1, +8, so I add 9 to this, which hits. It's an undead, so I do three points of damage to it. I do 4 points of damage to it. How did I... It's almost cheating that I found that Holy Avenger, but I'm going to count it as fate because I had shuffled. What I didn't know is if maybe that's not even supposed to be in the game, but maybe it is. You don't mind, right? Right, chat? You're not being talkative enough to tell me not to do that, so. However, I've already moved, so therefore an event happened, an encounter. A thin layer of ice makes it difficult to stand in one place. Let's see. Attack each hero on the active hero's tile. After the attack, place each hero on the active hero's tile. On a tile within one tile of the active hero's tile. Heroes can be placed on different tiles. Doesn't say I have to move them. After the attack, place each hero on the active hero's tile on a tile within one tile of the active hero's tile. I'm just going to skip it. It's an automatic damage. I'm going to skip it by getting rid of these cards. That's 2, 4, 5 points worth of cards. I'm going to discard. Now it is my turn. I will move. 1, 2, explore. You see me? Tile. black tile, and it's another corner. I'm freaking lost. It has a zombie on it. And it's a black tile, so we draw another one of these. Event. A monster flees from you to seek help. If there are no monsters in play, discard this card. There is. Draw a tile from the bottom of the dungeon stack and place it adjacent to the unexplored edge that is closest to the active hero. Place the monster closest to the active hero on that tile and place a new monster on that tile. Do not draw an encounter. Well, crap. Draw from the bottom. That means I don't get closer to my stairway. It's a hallway, which is fine. He runs to here. I draw another one. It's a rat swarm. There's now a rat swarm on that tile. And now their turn. You get that in order of draw. So the zombie is within one tile of a hero. It is not. Otherwise, it moves towards me, so it's going to come back. Rat swarm. Not within one tile, so it moves towards me. You went and got help with a rat swarm. Wonderful. I'm in trouble here a little bit in that. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 isn't going to be anywhere, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 doesn't get me far enough either. But I can run that way and then shoot some fire at him. Zombie will end up. Well, they get a plus one damage for every zombie they hit. So, that's alright. I get attacked by them unless I run this way. Run this way, I'm too close to Strahd. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, you know what? I'll stay right there. Can I attack each thing that's adjacent? Anything allows me to attack everything adjacent. Shield of Faith. What is that? I can always use my Shield of Faith. So I will use my Healing Strike to attack the Rat Swarm. Though it's not undead. Where's the alarm? Right, we gotta pull that out of here. Hey, we got someone there. Who's that? Crom, how you doing? How you doing, Crom? I'm getting attacked in this... in the dungeons. Let's see, where are they? Here's the alarm trap. Oh, I just killed this zombie, so... isn't he a cool-looking zombie, though? And it is now hero phase. Or no, villain phase. The trap will go off. You know what? I don't know if it goes off on this one. I guess it does. Place a new monster on the unexplored edge that is closest to the alarm marker. That's right here. And it will be a wolf. A wolf has heard the noise. Wonderful. Okay. Now it's my turn. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will attack him with our healing strike. We will hit him. Healing strike saved me one. Kills him. And then we'll, oh, then I explore. Oh wait, gotta get my treasure. Lucky find! Draw 3 treasure cards and keep one. Discard the others. Well, that'll work. 1. Blessing, run. 2. Card experience. This card counts as 1 experience point. And days. Put this card face up on the monster card. The next time the monster would activate, discard the card, it's dead. Well, I killed the monster, so... I'm doing alright. I was hoping to be playing this with Dawson, but... he's doing something else. Not me. That sounds really bad on a lonely kill team. No, I'm doing alright. Strahd's about to... ooh. No, Strahd's probably about to wake up. I will keep the Harrowed experience. Get me 1 extra experience points, because that's all I got. Hey, bud. Speak of the devil.
What, you talking about me?
Crom said hi, and I told you where you were. Feasting on French onion soup. Now that's a feast. Do you get those, like, the crunchy, you know, the crunchy onions that you can dump in there? That you put on with, like, the French onion, French cut, whatever it is, Thanksgiving when you have the beans. Bean stuff. Let me explore here. A rubber mallet and safety glasses.
Yeah,
what are you doing?
What
are you doing?
I'm just unsticking those bolts.
Unsticking bolts. There you go. Okay, good news, bad news. It's a black triangle. Good news is I don't wake the sun up anymore. A wraith. That's not so good news. Nice. Apparently my Google is... Messenger's trying to help me. It just said, try saying, send a message. Don't send a message. Crazy, stupid phone. Wraith. There's a wraith. It's my wraith. Ooh, spooky. There's the wraith. See, is that other... camera pick that up? It can. If I move that there. Here. There we are. It's my foe. It is his turn. The Wraith is not within one... It is within one tile. It moves adjacent to the closest hero and attacks that hero with a life-draining claw. Booga booga. Booga booga booga. Eek. He rolls a 15, adding 6 to it is 21. He does 3 damage to me. Ouch. Puts me at half strength. Special ability, Death Shriek. Whenever this monster is destroyed, each hero on tile takes damage. Well, that sucks. Now it's my turn. Do I want to hit him on this tile because I'll take damage? Yes, I do. I will use the Holy Avenger Sword in my Healing Strike. Rolling a 20, which will hit, which gains me a hit point back. It does 3 points of damage. Plus my normal damage, so it does 4 points, killing the Wraith. The Wraith does 1 point of damage back to me as he gets killed and, like, explodes or something. I get a... immediately get a bonus point. Eagle Eyes. Place 1 tile from the top of the dungeon stack adjacent to any unexplored edge. Place any new monsters on that tile as normal, but do not draw an encounter card. Is that helpful? I guess it can be helpful. Because it makes it closer. I'm looking right here. The end of this one. Another crypt. Monster goes on that. It is a skeleton. We'll go on to that. Find a nice looking skelly. Here we got this cool looking skeleton. So can you see that skeleton? Seems soon enough. Okay, now it's my turn to move. I will just move right here. And I'm right in the middle, and I will explore this way. And it is a white tile. That means that the sun is one step closer. It will Strahd will wake up on the next turn. For the next time that I draw a white tile. It's here. Let's see that. Hey, cool. Is that like make my eyeball big? Beans wants to know if you worked on this game. She says she swears she remembers you saying it. I've painted things from this game. No, I didn't work on this game. I helped play test a couple games, but not this game. If that's what she's talking about. We helped play test some stuff for a guy that works at a game company nearby, which was really cool, and I can't talk about it, except that much, I suppose, and it wasn't this, but this game is something that you can mess around with, and you can customize things, so there's all these cards, you can mix and match with these other ones and make your own custom game, so that also might be something she's heard. So, I'm not going to say she's wrong. Okay. Let's see, I just explored there. I got to find another rat swarm is there. It's right here. No, rats. Why'd it have to be rats? And now it's their go. So the skeleton moves first. If the skeleton... is adjacent. It is not. If it's within one tile, it is. It moves adjacent. And attacks with a charging slice. I have to decide which place I want to put him. Because... be able to do different things depending on where I put him. I will move him attacking me from here. There you go. And his charging slice is a 18 plus 9. That's going to hit me for 2 more damage. Oh! I might die this turn. Although you can't die. I have healing surge. So that's 6 out of my 8 hit points are gone, and he is done. The rat swarm moves onto my tile and attacks everybody in it, which is of course me, and rolls a 20, so 1 more point. Luckily I have healing surges before I lose the game. It is now my turn. I could attack both of them with a flame strike. Though I'm not sure, I might need that for... would automatically kill both of them. Yeah, I think I'm gonna zap those two. I will... A column of flame engulfs your foes. Choose a tile within 2 tiles of you. And on this one. Attack each monster on that tile. I can do up to 3 points of damage to them. However, since they only take 1 each and I can automatically do 1, they both die. I get to draw 1 treasure. I can't get more than 2 in a turn. I get to place this card face up on top of either the encounter deck or the monster deck. The next time a card would be chosen from that deck, discard this card. I will put it on... Oh, shoot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think I'm about to find the way out, so I will put it on, well, I'll put it on the monster deck. And move them. And I'll move. 1, 2, 3. Explore. That's where I need to get to. And Strahd wakes up. So on the villain phase, I might escape this thing, because he's a long way away. Strahd, where is he? He's unpainted. There he is. Hello, I am Strahd. He starts on his crypt. What's it say? Tactics. If he has 5 hit points or fewer... Nope, he's got more than that. If he's within 1 tile, he's not. If he's within 1 tile, no. If he is 5, no. Otherwise, move 2 tiles towards the hero. Look at that. I'm going to so win. He goes 1, 2. So for my turn, all I have to do is go 1, 2, right in here. Actually, I might as well go 3, because that means I can explore. That, then I would have a monster come. However, the next monster is this guy, which is a non-monster, so no monster comes. Oh, I should have read something when Strahd comes. When the sun sets, somewhere in the darkness behind you, you hear the sound of stone scraping on stone. It must be the sound of Strahd's coffin lid sliding open. The vampire lord has awakened. And then he ran there. Then victory. You win the game when a hero starts his or her turn on the secret stairway tile. Well, there you go. I just won, though, dude. Boom. That was too easy. Although it wasn't. However, go on to play Adventure 2. We can add a character in there. Because even if I didn't, let's see, I would go 1, 2, and he would draw one of these, and I would cast these cards, use these cards, and not have to do that. I've never kicked ass that much on this game. It must be the French onion soup.